Oh, it's yourself, HandyAndy. Come away in. Sit down.
Let's see what we've got here.
Would you like to talk about anything on your mind?
Yes. Ash, let's talk. I would like to talk about gaming season in general. Mm-hmm. And obviously, gaming season to us at TTSC is the last couple of months of the year when they bring out all the big titles. Big titles being FIFA, Battlefield, Grand Theft Auto. Every fucking one's a blue moon.
Mm-hmm.
And Call of Duty. Normally Assassin's Creed. Normally.
aye. It's been sadly missed this year.
Yes. So, also I'd like to get your opinions on this year's gaming season. In general, the titles that have come out. Is there anything you obviously you've mentioned there that Assassin's Creed is clearly missing? That's mm-hmm. the one major title that's missing.
But I mean, I know that they brought out the Ezio collections, but I think that's just that's a bit poor from them. I'd say the definite winner this season's been Battlefield, without a shadow of a doubt. However, it does have its major flaws. And one being, honest to God, after two games, you want to play something else. It's quite boring just now. I think they'll need to bring out quite a bit more DLC for it. Free updates, not DLC. That's been pretty much it. I've not been overly excited by anything else. What about yourself?
I personally, it's been a bit of a letdown gaming season compared to recent years.
Hmm.
Obviously, due to my sabbatical, I missed last year's gaming season. But looking at the titles not that came out last season, I didn't miss much apart from maybe Six Siege. Division,
mm-hmm.
Misty ones. Being a part of this season's gaming season, you know me, I bought pretty much every title that was there to buy. This gaming season, get Mafia 3, get FIFA 17, Battlefield 1, get Grand Theft Auto, get my normal WWE, also Call of Duty as well, remastered Legacy version,
mm-hmm.
and. See, to be honest with you, for all the games that came out this gaming season, right, obviously I listed the games here that I bought, I've still got them here, this copy, the only digital copy I've got is the Legacy Edition of Call of Duty, and for all these games that I've bought in the past couple of months, the game that I've spent most time playing has been Rocket League.
Exactly.
I don't know. I'm not too sure why that is. However, it is a bit embarrassing for games and games companies like EA, who brought out two games, 2K, who brought out WWE, and then obviously, is it Activision that brought out Call of Duty this year?
Yeah, I think so. I'm pretty sure we'll get told otherwise if it wasn't it.
So, it's quite embarrassing for me the fact that, I've bought every single one of the games and we are, heavy gamers. We like to play our games. We like to play them for hours at a time.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and the fact that for hours at a time, I'm spending playing Rocket League, a free game that we got here 2 years ago.
Exactly.
Instead of playing these latest titles. I mean, I say latest titles, obviously, you know, Call of Duty brought out the remastered version of mm-hmm. Modern Warfare. And to be honest with you, I haven't even started playing Infinity Warfare yet. Obviously, due to obvious reasons, and I've spoken about this before. But, as you know, and as has been updated in the past couple of days, next week on PlayStation Now,
mm-hmm.
we will be receiving the greatest game of all time, in Oof. The TTSC's opinion, with the Red Dead Redemption being available on PlayStation Now. I think that's going to take up pretty much most of our time in the next couple of months, to be honest with you.
Exactly. Now, how would that work then? How does the whole PlayStation Now thing work? Is it you pay money and then that's you got the game?
Well, I've not had it since it first came out. And now, when it first came out, you rented the games. However, a few people have told me, and I'm pretty sure the viewers know about this, they could update us on it, because I've not had it since you had to rent the games, because that was a lot of shite, in my opinion. But I'm pretty sure nowadays it is basically you pay a fee, or I think it's $11.99 per month. For example, $9.99 a month, and there's a list of games, back catalogue games that you can play
right
through the streaming system, which is a great idea. Xbox has got a pretty much similar.
Well, see, that's what I was going to say. I think that's where PSN falls short against Xbox yet again, because all Xbox simply done was made Red Dead Redemption backwards capability, or whatever the fuck you call it. So,
capability.
So if you've got Red Dead, you can play it, and you don't need to pay so much a month or whatever.
And to be honest with you, with the upcoming major event that's happening next year, next autumn, with Red Dead Redemption 2, i.e. Red Dead 3, and I'm going to throw a wee prediction here. Right. I think it's going to be delayed.
Oofed.
Troops, don't hate the messenger, just listen to the facts. It's happened with majority of the Grand Theft Auto games, and Grand Theft Auto games tend to come out in the spring. Look at your history, and you'll know this. So I think it's going to be delayed till the spring 2018.
Oof.
And with this big event that's coming up next year, I thought it would have been a perfect time, especially with no titles in the past couple of years for Rockstar. I think it would have been a perfect time for them to bring a remastered version of Red Dead Redemption. See if they brought out a remastered version of Red Dead Redemption and not told us about the new game, then it would have got folk excited again.
Aye, hit us with the remastered version first. Let that be out there for, I don't know, 8, 9, a year, whatever it is, and then go, oh, by the way, she coming in the next month, Red Dead Redemption 2.
Aye, maybe not even that, maybe like, have the remastered version out there for a couple of months, and my case, all right, Rockstar saying, now you've had a taste of what was Red Dead Redemption. Being released on, say, the 27th of October 2017, we are releasing Red Dead Redemption 2. Because my prediction was, obviously, it's going to be carry on from the story. And being Red Dead Redemption 2, it sounds that way. And I think that would be the perfect way for people. The amount of people we've spoke to have never played the game. Like new gamers who weren't lucky enough to have a copy of Red Dead Redemption, and see people who didn't have a copy. I swear to God.
They need to take it and show it.
Because you missed one of the best games ever.
It's definitely my favourite. Definitely.
Right, so this month, obviously on Battlefield, if you've not heard already, then where the fuck have you been? But this month, we're getting some free DLC on Battlefield 1, and obviously TTSC, I'm looking forward to that one. Bremmer, what's been exciting you this month?
Well, what's got my juices going was a game that got a lot of love at the start, and then a shitload of hate, and loads of folk traded it in, chucked it in the bin, fucking burned the CD, put the CD in the fucking microwave, blew it up because they hated the game that much, and that was The Division. Absolutely love The Division. And since, in the past month, we've had two major updates for it, 1.4, and the last one there, obviously, at 1.5, and I highly recommend, if anybody out there still has a working copy of The Division, you can pick it up cheap as chips these days. 20-odd quid will get you a copy of the Division. Go out, do yourself
maybe
a favour.
Less.
Probably even less. Get yourself a copy of the Division because it is playable again. The guns, it feels the way it did right at the start. The guns feel like guns. The enemies, the AI die and it feels like you're actually killing them and they're not just bullet sponges. It's very rewarding. And there's loads of new stuff in it, new weapons, new gear. And then coming for the PlayStation boys, I think it's just before Christmas, we're getting another update for it, which the Xbox already has, called Survival, which I'm super excited about. Basically, you're just, you think it's you and then a lobby of 30, maybe 20 odd folk, and you respawn with nothing, and you've got to survive the freezing temperatures, the free roaming AI try to kill you, and you've got nothing, so you need to go and scour about New York, Manhattan, and getting all this stuff and survive. And the last man standing wins a prize, so I'm fair looking forward to that.
Yeah, I've seen a few clips and articles about that, and personally, I'm considering getting the game for that.
Well, that's what we could do. We could, you get yourself a wee copy, and we'll bring a bit of footage to the channel. The Division. So it's a lovely day out there. Any plans today?
Well, it's TTSC Muscles Christmas night out tonight. So obviously I've got to go and make sure this bitch has got fucking Bahama Mamas looking chipping sharp. TTSC colours absolutely everywhere. Right, I'm up.
Right, we'll see you later then. Thanks for dropping by. There you go, troops. That's another wee let's talk in the can. Sorry for the fact my guy seems to be going on like an absolute fucking retard, but you know what I mean? Once you've got that vibe, you've got that vibe. Anyway, troops, thanks for watching. You stay special, motherfuckers. See you later.
America is for the Americans. When my grandparents came here from Norway, and Ireland, and the Ukraine, they didn't imagine they'd have to share the place with Mexicans, or anyone else for that matter. It just ain't right.